Hello, I welcome all the students for the lecture series of subject Theory of Computation. In the last lecture, we have learned unit number 2, that is regular expressions. And from that we understand what are the basic properties of regular expression, how we can represent the regular expression in the form of finite automata, as well as how we can find the regular expression from the finite automata using Arden's theorem. At the same time, how we are representing the language of regular expression, and that language we can call as a regular language. Now, today we will discuss an important topic, that is nothing but closure properties of regular languages. Now, the language accepted by the finite automata, is represented in the form of a simple expression, and that expression is called as the regular expression. And whatever the language accepted by the finite automata, that language is called as the regular language. Fine. Means the language which we are representing with the help of regular expression, that language we can call as a regular language. Now, today we will discuss some of the closure properties of regular languages. First property, that is closure under union. Now, what do we mean by closure under union? Let us consider that there is a language L1. If language L1 is a regular, and there is one more language L2, L2 is also a regular language. If there is a language L1, if it is a regular language, there is one more language L2, and that L2 is also a regular language, then L1 union L2, that is union operation, L1 union L2 is also a regular language. This property is called as the closure under union. A very simple property: if L1 is and L2 are regular languages, if L1 and L2, these two languages are regular languages, then L1 union L2 is also a regular language. So, that property is called as the closure property, okay, closure under union. We will take an example. Let us consider this L1 is the language, this L1 is a language which consists of even number of zeros. If L1 is a language which consists of even number of zeros. So, if I say even number of zeros means 0, 0, 4, 0, 6, 0 and so on. If the language L1 is a regular language which consists of even number of zero, and if I am having L2 language which consists of odd number of zeros. So, it is like 1, 0, 3 zeros, 5 zeros and so on. L1 and L2 both are regular languages. Then we can say L1 union L2, that is equals to 0, 00, 0, 3 0, 4 0, 5 0, 6 0 and so on is also a regular language. So, this property is called as the closure under union. Okay, very simple property, closure under union. Now, we will see, we will learn what is the second property. So, the second property of regular language is nothing but closure under second property of regular language is closure under concatenation. closure under concatenation. Now, what is closure under concatenation? If there are two languages, L1 and L2, and if both the languages are regular languages, if L1 and L2 both are regular languages, then L1 dot L2, then L1 dot L2, L1 concatenation L2 is also a regular language. So that property is called as the closure under concatenation. So if L1 and L2 are regular languages, then L1 dot L2, that is concatenation, if there are two languages, both are regular languages, and if I take concatenation of those two languages, then resulting language is also a regular language. That property is called as the closure under concatenation. That is your property number 2. Fine. So the third property of regular language is, third property of regular language is closure under clean start. Now, what is closure under clean start? See here. What is closure under clean start? If there is a language L, and if I say language L is a regular language, then clean start of that language L, if language L is a regular language, then clean start, that means L closure, is also a regular language, that is a clean start. If I say there is a language L is equals to, if I say like A, okay, then if this is a regular language, RL, then L star, that means I can say A star is also a regular language. That is the third property of regular language. Next property, property number 4 of regular language is, fourth property of regular language is closure under intersection. What is closure under intersection? If there are two languages, L1 and L2, and if both the languages are regular languages, if these are the regular languages, then intersection of L1 and L2 is also a regular language. Intersection of L1 and L2 is also a regular language. So that is the fourth property of regular language. So we have seen closure under union, closure under concatenation, closure under clean start. Fourth property is closure under intersection. If there are two languages, L1 and L2, if both the languages are regular language, then the intersection of L1 and L2 is also a regular language. Fifth property of regular language, is closure under difference. If there are two languages, L1 and L2, and if both the languages are regular language, then the difference of L1 and L2, that means L1 minus L2, is also a regular language. So, if the result of this difference L1 and L2 is also a regular language, fine. So that is called as closure under difference. Sixth property of regular language is closure under complementation. Closure under complementation. Now, what is this property? Closure under complementation. It says that if language L is a regular language, if language L is a regular language, then complement of that language L is denoted as L complement. Okay. Then the complement of that language L is also a regular language. Is also a regular language. Complement of that language L is also a regular language. For example, if there is a language L which consists of even number of zeros, 2 zeros, 4 zeros, 6 zeros, and so on. If it consists of even number of zeros or even number of A's or B's, whatever it may be, then complement of that language L, that is odd number of zeros, 1, 3, 5, is also a regular language. If I call L is a regular, then L complement is also a regular language. Complement of that particular language is also a regular language. That is represented as L dash. Okay, complement is represented as L dash. Then the seventh property of a regular language is closure under reversal. Seventh property of regular language is closure under reversal. That means if language L is a regular language, then reverse of that language L is also a regular language. Reverse of that language L is also a regular language. For example, I am writing one language which consists of 0, 0, 1, then 0, 0, 1, after that I will say 0, 1, 0, and so on. Then the reverse of that particular language, if this is a regular language, then reversal of that language is 0, 0, 1, it means it is 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and so on, is also a regular language. So these are the few properties of regular languages, and those properties are called as the closure properties of regular languages. Okay, so I'll stop here. That's it about the closure properties of regular languages. In the next lecture, we will learn what are the applications of regular expression. That is the important point. What are the applications of regular expression? That we will discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.